In the centre of the ground, up they go. Goodall got the tap, gave it down there towards Chara Lambis. Left foot kicked from Hode. Had 12 possessions in that first half. Troy Hode standing there firm, though, for the Doggies. Good mark by Josh McCleary. Went across the face, found Haddock. Haddock gets onto the left foot, looking for the run of Speedy. He's got him now out of wing position. Speedy needs to show exactly that. Wasn't great at doing it, though. McCleary put him under all sorts of pressure. Tackled him nicely. Good play there by Ambrose. Took the hit. Went to ground. They dive on top of it. Michael Burke's in there and dumped on his head there was McCleary. Eventually, the umpire will come in and bounce. Out of sight of the ground. So thanks very much to the Mornington Football Club for their hospitality during the halftime break. Greatly appreciated as the ball goes in towards the 50-metre line. Oh, wonderful mark over the back. Hasn't been paid, has it? Yes, it has. Terrific mark.
Kane McKenzie. Great mark.
Goes backwards up towards Van Ray. Van Ray sweeps across. Paxton, this is where they've been good today, the Bulls. Goes further up the line. Good mark there by Timmy Hurst. Tim Hurst has got Paxton again, and they're happy just to chip the ball out of the defensive zone, the Bulls. So Paxton saw something short that he liked. That was Jack Johnson. Decides to go back across the other side of the ground. Noble sold some candy. Decided to go back. Goes back and takes his kick now. Gave it to McGarry. McGarry now wants to launch. Goes further up the field. Terrific kick too. Found Tim Hurst. Gave it to Troy Hode. Now they can build the Bulls. Goes towards the 50-metre line. That's a wonderful kick of the footy. Alanis sweeping handball to Burke. Burke runs around. Thought he might have had a shot. Back to Alanis. Sweeping kick for goals. A lovely one. That's a great... No, it's not. Or it is. Yes, it is. Just not enough excitement to... No.
Just the minor, Towie.
It was a fair bit of excitement. Yeah, there was some excitement and there was no excitement. I was getting all excited. James Cameron's got the footy now. Defensive 50. Switches play. He's got Matthews now. If he wants him, decides not to go down that path. All of a sudden, he's got to kick off one step. It was always going to be a pressure kick. It was a free kick there. No.
There was.
To Cal Dixon. Pushing the back. There's got to be a free kick second time round. The umpire's calling play on. Now he's going to bring it back. It'll be a free kick to the Bulls, and it'll go down there towards David Hurst for in the back.
And that was on the Boss Sports replay.
It was. Boss Sports looking after us with a number of things today. Statistics, yes. Our replays, yes. And of course the best man on the ground.
Go down and see Barry, he'll look after you.
And Pest are free, looking after us with the scoreboard. So David Hurst has one goal. He kicked the first goal of the game for the Bulls. Has a flying shot. He's kicked, missed it to the near side through for a minor score. So it's 3 goals, 10-28 to 6-6. 6-7, in fact. 6-7-42. And that is on the pest-free scoreboard. The Doggies are bringing a ball in very, very quickly. Speedy's got it. Left foot goes to the boundary line. And he's found Searle out there. Searle's not too sure who to go to. Still inside defensive 50.
They need to hurry it on.
Decides to go along the line again. Not the greatest of kick, but Jackson Calder comes out and takes a contested mark. Needs to do more of it, Jackson. He had a quiet second quarter. Was pretty good in the opening quarter. Again, goes backwards looking for Haddock. Haddock now wants to run and carry. Barry Smeaton's the obvious target to go to. That's a really dangerous handball. Haddock dives on top of it. Comes out to Michael Burke. Kicks it over his head, Michael Burke, if you don't mind.
Soccer style.
Wonderful play there by Michael Burke. Went over the top of his head, kicked a goal. That's his third for the afternoon. And that's goal number 7 for the Bulls. They move on to 7 goals, 7 to Mornington, 3 goals, 10. And the game just starting to get away from the Doggies
now.
Absolutely,
Towie. I just think they were a little bit scrambled then and gave a silly decision. Not decision, sorry, but it was a stupid kick and went to ground and Burke finished it off.
So Goodall wins the tap once again. They need to respond here. The Dogs are in more trouble than a Werribee Duck at the moment. There's a free kick. It's going Coringle's way. It's going down there to Ambrose. So Ambrose, Harley Ambrose, one of the best names in footy, I reckon, Harley Ambrose, is goes down towards Bray. He took the contested mark for the Doggies. Sweeping handball found Bitters. Bitters has got to start getting his hands on the footy. Gets it now. Wasn't a great handball. Comes out there towards Coyle. Sold some candy. Back to Bitters. Bitters goes up towards full forward. Baker comes out. It was good work by him. He crashed the pack. Did it nicely. He's hurt, though, as Troy Hode sweeps on the loose ball. Gives it to Charalambos. A sweeping handball. Gave it there. Towards Jack Johnson. Another one towards Timmy Hurst. He gets it back now. Goes out wide looking for Paxton. They're not cracking under the pressure here. The Bulls, they're working it out beautifully. Oh, there's a bit of how do you do between Smeaton and Cal Dixon there. A couple of big haymakers were thrown in there. Keep an eye on that one. Short pass. Peter Bain dives on top of the footy. Comes out there towards Ryan Smith. Smith gets it now. Had a quiet first half. Kicks it toward Calder, and Calder takes the mark. So Calder takes the mark. About 50 metres out from goal, needs to kick it.
Little bit of Roman wrestling there going on, Towie, but it's all cleared. So well sorted by the umpire there.
Jackson Calder needs to kick this one for the Dogs. It's not the greatest kick. He started it right. It stayed out there. Didn't come back enough through for a minor score. So it's 3 goals, 11-29 Mornington trailing. Coringle 7-7-49.
The Dogs really need to keep it in their forward 50 to kick a goal and add that scoreboard pressure.
So the ball comes back out to Luke Van Raid. Just a bit of kick to kick there as it comes out towards Noble. He's got to go. Couldn't take the mark. Was able to recover nicely though. He's got Troy Hode. He's been the best man on the ground for mine in the first half of footy. Comes out there. Free kick's got to go there towards Hurst. That's David Hurst. Kicks the ball long to the square. Michael Burke's got a couple to beat. Third man up there was Bitters. Crashed the ball over the boundary line. Justin Peckett, not all that happy. Thought that he had some space and that Tim Hurst should have went to him instead of the square.
They're definitely looking for Burke at the moment. He's looking very dangerous in the forward 50.
Left forward pocket for the Bulls. Another one could just about end Mornington, you feel, as the kick off the ground. Buddha Hurst going in there hard. Eames is in there as well. Mornington defence just holding up in the last line. And again, that's Emilio Bitters down there. Up he gets now. So umpire Peter Marshall throws the ball up, point of the square. Little kick out there from Ambrose. Went across the face through for a minor score. So good work to the Bulls once again, just locking the ball in. They move on to 7 goals, 8-50. Mornington 3-11-29. 21 points the difference on the pest-free scoreboard. Cal Searle to bring the ball back in, does so. Kicks it to Adrian Speedy. So Speedy plays on now, left kick. Left foot kick, in fact, goes out towards Bray, and it's a free kick against him. Goes to Luke Van Ray. Goes in short. Wasn't a great kick. Goes down there towards Hurst. Hurst kicks it to the point of the square, but it's all Mornington, and taking the mark there was Searle. Goes in short, looking for and finding Coyle. Coyle wants to play on. Needs some support. Decides to go for a chip up the line. Gives it to Ryan Smith, who's starting to get his hands on the footy now for the Doggies. Half back line. Goes up the line. It's all Coringle. Dan Noble should take the mark and does so. Plays on immediately to Tim Hurst. Tim Hurst goes inside there towards Charalambos. Unloads. Kicks it towards the 50-metre line. Good work there by Cal Dixon. Almost took the mark. Recovered very well. Goes to ground and eventually the umpire will come in and bounce. About 60 metres around from the Bulls' goal. Kicking towards the main street end in this third quarter.
The tools for the Bulls are just really dominating the play. As soon as the ball's up in the air, it just one of their big hands get it.
Good work there by Byron Holt to bring the ball to ground. Bray just to kick around the corner. Didn't get any purchase on it. They dive on top of it again. The umpire letting the game go. Good work there, Byron Holt. Just trying to crash his way out of the traffic there. But also up to the challenge was Justin Peckett to hang on for dear life and stop him from going anywhere. So up they go again. Good work there by Holt. The umpire's plucked out a free kick. It's going towards Mornington, and it goes to Byron Holt. Goes towards Matthews. Matthews sweeping kick to the full back position. Gave it to Bray. Bray to Speedy. Speedy dropped perhaps what he should have taken. Fell over at the critical moment. Got a kick. His quick kick to it. sitting under it there was Moss. Comes out there towards McCleary. Gave a little handball off now. Goes towards Smith. And once again, Smith gets the ball on the centre of the ground. Smeaton wanted it on the wing position. He didn't want to go to him there. Needs to go long. Tries to get around Baker. Byron Holt, he's got a couple to beat now. Great work by Hurst. Smith was able to work his way back into the contest. Comes to Matthews. The umpire said play on, should have been dropping the ball. Comes out towards Bleisner. Little handball to Dixon, didn't go to anyone in particular. Matthews gets a handball out. Tim Hurst, he works at ground level. Dives on top of it, trying to get the ball out. Does so now. Hode gets tackled there by McCleary and Francina. And eventually the umpire will come in and bounce. Right in front of our commentary position. It is the Jim's test and tag commentary position, of course.
Desperation footy there by both teams, just wanting that ball.
Byron Holt got his fist to the ball on that occasion. McCleary tried to get away. Hurst, that's David Hurst. Got one a little bit high. The umpire said nothing in it. And he'll throw the ball back into play. That is the umpire right in front of our camera position. In we go. It's Bleisner up against Holt. Bleisner did well on that occasion. Kicked it towards the centre of the ground. McGarry kept his feet. Speedy fell over. Alanis grabs the footy. They merge on top of him. Smeaton's in there. Jesus, a sea of players there. The umpire just letting the game go. But eventually he has little choice but to call for it back and restart play. Just forward of the centre. Mornington's way. We've played 11 minutes in the third quarter.
Just the Bulls playing Mornington's game at the moment, or vice versa, at very scrappy football.
Kick in from Speedy, goes towards Calder, bounced over his head. Couldn't go there, was Bain as well, but once again, Paxton, he's got some support there. That was by Matthews, and geez, ticky touchwood stuff there. They almost got themselves into a world of trouble. Eventually, have spilled over the line and through for a minor score. Paxton wanting to bring the ball back into play, does so now. Comes towards the member side of the ground. Peckett's got a couple to beat. Happy to play at ground level. Finally comes down there towards Brewer. Brewer goes into the centre of the ground. Why he didn't go for goals beyond me. But once again, Coringle have got the numbers there. Comes out beautifully there to Nick Shaw. He's kicked a goal this afternoon. Joel's got it now. Joel with a sweeping handball to McGarry. McGarry runs to 40. Has a shot for goal. Misses.
Towie, I'm just not getting Mornington's football at the moment. Should have gone for goal, but decided to centre the ball, and it turned out to be a turnover.
So the ball goes up towards the wing position again. Jay Haddock, he dives on top of the footy. He's been one of Mornington's best today. Stewie Seeger goes in hard, can't come away with the footy, and the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. I said that McGarry had a shot from 40. It was more like about 70.
Yeah, it was. It was, so, but I think the option...
Don't go buying land from me.
I think the option, though, was to go deep in the square, but he decided to centre the ball and it resulted in a turnover.
So Anthony Simpson, he dived on top of the footy. Again, the umpire will come in and bounce half forward. The ball sits at the moment for the Doggies. They need to kick the next one. They trail by 21 points, so they're still in the contest at the 13-minute mark of the third quarter, but they need to... reduce the margin to at least a couple of goals. They just can't get two in a row this afternoon. Troy Hode, well tackled. The umpire just allowing the game to go on. Plenty of numbers around the footy, and eventually he's left with little choice yet again but to throw the ball up half forward for the Dogs, kicking towards the scoreboard end. That is the pest-free scoreboard end.
Pest-free.
Mm-hmm.
Scientifically tested, Towie.
Correct.
Australian made.
Crowd numbers, they should come in shortly, to Pest Free.
Yeah, the mail is that it'll be within the next 3 or 4 minutes.
So the ball comes out towards Speedy, needs to kick the footy, he does. Calder's caught under it again. Jumps high, couldn't take the mark. Moss at the ground level, couldn't get it. Good work there by McKenzie, just tapped the ball in front of himself.
Oh.
Moss got one across the chops. Joel's got to go backwards, finds Paxton. Paxton kicks the ball towards half back, going hard there was Matthews, couldn't take the ball with him. They got the numbers here, much more desperate for the footy, Coringle.
Absolutely,
and it's showing at the moment.
It is, really is showing.
Mornington still trying to be a little bit too cute in this contest and paying the price at the moment on the scoreboard. So up they go again. Bleisner doing the job in the ruck, then lays the tackle. Great second effort from the big fella. They need to get around him and support him because that was terrific work by the big fella in the ruck. Anthony Joel around the ball. Also, there's Harley Ambrose. He's able to get his mitts on the ball again. Good work by Nick Shaw. Finally comes out towards Smeaton. Smeaton kicks the ball up towards full forward. Getting caught under the footy, though, is Jackson Calder. And he gave a free kick away in the process. Again, two-on-one situation. And Paxton gets the free kick. Goes wide, looking for Tim Hurst. Finds him up against the boundary line, out of sight of the ground. Plays on, kicks the ball up towards the wing position. Could have got one in the back, Van Ray. Umpire said nothing in it. Comes down there towards Jimmy Cameron. Little left foot grubber along the boundary line. Allows McGarry to swoop on it. Goes out wide to Alanis. Alanis has got a bit of time up his sleeve. Goes towards the 50-metre line. Burke's got to beat his opponent there in Searle. Not able to do it. Peckett, clever little kick inside. Found Charalambos. And not sure it travelled the required distance on that occasion.
No, I wouldn't have thought it would. I think they got away with that one.
They did.
But he lines up about 45 out on a slight angle. No wind here today, Towie. Very brisk, mate.
Not even a zephyr.
Not even a zephyr. Very brisk.
It is.
But not much wind to mention.
Snow not far away.
No.
But, 21 minutes gone. Lucky we brought our beanies.
Yes.
For our bald heads. Or my bald head.
Your bald head.
And there's a goal to Charalambos, and it's getting a little ugly now in a tight contested game. Coringle are able just to stretch the margin to 27. 8 goals, 9.57. Leading Mornington 3.12.30. We've played 16 minutes. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula football.
Don't just dream about the great outdoors. Rip and a raise and make it yours. With 25% off all stretches. 20% off RM Williams Stockyard Apparel Range. And get 40% off Wild Country Workwear. These deals and more at Raise Outdoors. In store and online at raiseoutdoors.com.au. Make the outdoors yours at Raise Outdoors.
Station sponsor.
So we're back in the heat of the battle. The Dogs have got to kick the next one. They're in all sorts of trouble at the moment. Michael Burke, wonderful defensive pressure on Emilio Bitters there. Searle's got a couple to beat. Little chip kick was too cute again. They're just smelling some blood at the moment. The Bulls, another flying shot for goal. Push it across the face. That was Motors head. And the ball goes over the line. Barry Smeaton just getting some treatment out there, short pass.
Yes, yep, absolutely. Just getting worked over.
Crowd don't like him.
No.
Coringle players aren't enjoying him at the moment either, as the ball's with Simpson. Had to dodge and weave, eventually kicks it up there towards Mosh, but there's Luke Van Ray, just chipped in, took the mark, gets the ball on the boot, kicks it up towards half forward. Matthews, he's in some trouble down there. Good play there by Alanis, needs some support. Going in hard there as well. Just trying to pick that player up. I reckon
it's Cameron,
might be Mottershead again. It is Mottershead. And he attacked the footy very well for the Bulls at half forward. So they're attacking again, Coringle. They lead comfortably by 27 points. There's Charalambos. He's already kicked one. He kicked the last one. He has a shot from half forward. That's a lovely looking kick. That's a great kick there by Steve Charalambos. He's kicked 2 goals in 2 minutes. And that's goal number 8. 8 goals, 11.59 to 3.12.30. And another great work there by Steve Charalambos.
The Bulls supporters just getting up and about and letting them know that they are following them, Towie. They're getting very, very boisterous and are enjoying the lead.
One of the best crowds in the business in Mornington Peninsula Football, Coringle's crowd.
Speaking of crowds, Towie, I've just been given the mail, mate. It's 456 today attendance, and that's brought to us by Boss Sports of Mornington. Go down and see Barry.
Good, Baz. We all love Baz at Boss Sports. And meanwhile, flying shot a goal there from Carl Brewer. Went through for a minor score. So the free kick, or the kicking in fact, will go there towards Paxton. Likes what he sees towards the member side of the ground. It's Jack Johnson. Just sings a few tunes in the off season, does Jack Johnson. As the ball goes to the outer side of the ground, Frankie Peckett.
Quite a good surfer too, Jack.
Yes, correct. Does it all, Jack
does
Johnson.
Does it all, yes.
Peckett, they're just happy to possess the footy in the back half, aren't they, Coringle, until it opens up for them. Johnson gets the hands on the footy again, and once again it opens up. Member side of the ground, goes to the big fella in Bleisner. Noble probably should have stood down while his team. Mander's in all sorts of trouble there. Good play by McCleary. Stewie Seeger gave it to Calder. Calder goes in short, looks for and finds Daniel Moss.
Now they really need to use a football here, Towie. They can't rush it.
Moss now goes long. It's 3-on-2. Smeaton came over the back, but eventually the ball spills over and it goes through for another minor score.
Quick to bring it back in.
So 8-11-59 to 3-13. So they're doing it nicely. And in meanwhile, the Doggies have kicked themselves a goal. Turnover there wasn't great. And as a result, it is Anthony Simpson who's able to chip in and kick the goal for the Doggies. A much needed one for
Absolutely.
Them.
Absolutely. Great goal by Simpson then. Unfortunately, the kick out wasn't too successful. And Simpson brought it to ground, was able to swing around and kick a very nice goal from the boundary line.
So they needed that one. Can they kick two goals in a row for the first time this afternoon? They haven't been able to do it. As Timmy Hurst comes off for a well-earned break, he's played a terrific game in the defence today.
He's
also kicked a goal, so he's done everything. As the ball comes back in, great work there by Goodall, who's stripped off the long sleeve and goes for the short sleeve. Great kick towards full forward.
Oh.
There he is again. There he is again, Michael Burke.
Fantastic grab by Michael Burke in the
Fondly known in Coringle circles as Butthead.
Butthead.
But it's been a wonderful, wonderful footballer for many years for the Coringle Footy Club. This is to kick goal number 4, and they've got the answer. Didn't kick through it, just dobbed it in, and lovely goal there to him. There's goal number 14 for the Bull. Goal number 4 for Burke, and goal number 9 for the Bulls.
Not what the Dogs needed, Toey. That was a little bit too easy. Started off in the centre. They got the clearance, and then before you knew it, it was in Burke's hands. So quick move of the football. Impressive by the Bulls.
It was terrific work. They've been able to answer the challenge all afternoon.
Absolutely.
We've played 21 minutes in the third quarter. Michael Burke with 4 goals this afternoon. Ball in the centre of the ground again. Ducking and weaving. Anthony Joel couldn't get away from a tackle. Head-high tackle there.
High.
That's against... Not sure who that was against down there. It might have been Stewie Seeger, the coach, who laid that tackle.
Not quite sure, Toby. The umpire was front and centre. Didn't see that one.
So Goodall, he gets an easy tap on that occasion. Comes down to Smeaton. Smeaton goes up towards full forward. Calder again. Gets under the footy. Finally comes down towards Moss.
To
Moss from 50 has a shot for goal.
That's
He's brought
goal.
It back. It's a lovely goal. Gives the fist bump.
They're excited.
He enjoyed that one, Daniel Moss. And they've kicked 2 of the last 3. They move on to 5 goals, 14-44. That's on the pest-free scoreboard.
Fantastic, fantastic goal then. Definitely what the Dogs needed. Just need to continue on with the momentum and hopefully make this a cracking game.
Let's go to Geordie. Statistics inside 50s in this quarter, Geordie King.
Mornington have had 6 inside 50s to Coringle's 11.
What about clearances, Geordie?
Coringle 5 to Mornington 3.
Luke Van Ray possessions this quarter.
He's only had 4.
Okay, so the ball's back inside the forward line for the Dogs, but once again, McKenzie's over to bring the ball out. Left foot kick, kicked it up towards the wing position. Ambrose got tackled, didn't have the footy. David Hurst doing plenty of work off the ball there. Finally comes down there towards Baker. Wasn't his greatest effort. Somehow it stayed in, though. Eventually it gets smashed over the line and out of bounds. Umpire Peter Marshall says, throw the ball back in, please, gentlemen. Half forward for the Dogs. Yet to kick 2 goals in a row this afternoon. Blyzner, it wasn't good all. Did well. Cameron gets one a little bit high. Then he gets slammed into the ground. UFC style. WWE style. Call it what you will, but he was thrown
it
to the
was
ground.
Rough.
He was thrown around like a rag doll there by Big Grant Goodall. Up they go again. Goodall, geez, a massive punch on that occasion. Couldn't pick up the footy. Finally comes out to Luke Van Ray again. Left foot kick up towards full forward. Michael Burke caught out of position on that occasion, gave the free kick away, and the Dogs will take the resultant free kick. Searle gave it there to Bray. Bray's got the ball. Inside defensive 50, not sure where to go, so he goes further back. We're in a bit of trouble here, the Dogs. Got to provide something, and Callum Searle does. Gave the lead and took the mark on defensive 50, out of sight of the ground for the Doggies.
No one's moving forward for Searle, though, hence they have to... they really need to move around. I don't want to use that word, do we?
They do. Take after your father, using the word hence far too often.
It's a decent word.
As the ball goes up towards the wing position, out of sight of the ground. Noble got one for, or given a free kick away for pushing it back. So Calder gets the free kick, gives it to Speedy. Speedy's got to stop and prop and wait for something to present itself. Yeah. Goes to Jai Haddock. Geez, that was put him under all sorts of pressure. Once again, the Coringle defence outstanding. Sweeping handball from Charalambos was good to McGarry. McGarry goes for a shot at goal. Should have done better than that. And eventually it goes through for a minor score. So it's 5 goals, 14-44 Mornington. Coringle 10-10-70. Doing the job on the pest-free scoreboard. 25 minutes gone in the third quarter. Once again, won't be a long quarter. Searle goes back towards Bray. And eventually Bray, well, was touched and through for a minor score. So nothing going right for the Dogs at the minute.
Nah.
And this is Groundhog Day because they're doing exactly the same thing they did 30 seconds ago. Searle's got the ball in the left back pocket. Looking up the ground, kicks it straight to an opponent. It's a sad and sorry day for the Dogs at the moment
it
as Hurst goes across the face of goal. And look at that, they're queuing up. Justin Peckett takes an uncontested mark 40 metres out directly in front.
Peckett's a very good chance from here, Towie.
He's already kicked one this afternoon. Frankie Peckett, and it's all their little blokes once again. Yeah. David Hurst has one. Charalambos has two. Michael Burke has four. Chris Hay probably another couple of weeks away from coming back into this side. He'll be a welcome addition as well. As Justin Peckett, usually a wonderful kick of the footy. This time it's no exception. They move on to 11 goals, 12-78. Mornington 5 goals, 14-44. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula football.
Hi, I'm Michael Voss. For all the latest on what's happening in the sporting world, join me and Nick Turner every Saturday morning from 10.30 till 12 on the all-new RPP FM, 98.7 FM, sporting news and views.
Hi, this is Megan Gale, and when I'm on the peninsula, I love listening to RPPFM.
Oh, yes, and we love listening to you too, Megan Gale.
Megan.
And the ball's back in the centre of the ground. Great to have Megan as part of our stable of listeners every Saturday afternoon. 26 and 30 gone in the third quarter, and the siren sounds to mark three-quarter time. It was all Coringle once again. Mornington, anything that Mornington came up with, Coringle was able to answer.
That, he's waiting for the flashing light.
Correct, making sure that the camera's picking up the sparkling legs. Did some work in the solarium this morning as well, Pete Marshall, as the ball goes up again. Good work by Goodall. Going in hard there was Baker for Mornington. Comes out towards Stewie Seeger. He couldn't get a clear possession. Eventually, Franchina gets one. And he's back on the ground, or he's been on the ground and didn't touch it in the third, but it goes out wide. Great play there by Bray to force the spoil. Falling over at the critical moment. Geez, that's a wonderful tackle there. That was on Jack Johnson, I think it was. It comes out there towards Michael Burke. He dodges, weaves. He wanted the boundary line.
He took him on, didn't he?
He did, but he wanted the boundary line. He was just twisting and turning all the way towards the boundary, and eventually it goes over. So we're half forward for the Bulls, kicking towards the scoreboard end in this final quarter. Lovely little deft give it was from Goodall on that occasion. Dive on top of it. The umpire's found a free kick, and now he's paying advantage as his left foot kick comes from McGarry up towards full forward. Good work there by Ambrose at the four of the ball to keep the ball alive, and eventually attacked over and through for a minor score. So they move to 11 goals 13 to 5 goals 14. That is on the pest-free scoreboard this afternoon. The Dogs just trying to work the ball out again, only as far as Charalambos. Got the mark, ran around his opponent with ease, kicked it towards Burke, up towards full forward. He's got it now, gets on the left. Can he kick five? Not on this occasion. It's chipped off and taken mark there by Callum Searle in the last line of defence. Goes short, looking for Matthews, finds him. Defensive 50, outer side of the ground was a nice kick. Found Speedy, gave another one there to Jimmy Cameron, who takes the ball at half back. Where's this run been all day? Kicks it now towards half forward. Jack Johnson over the back, terrific mark. Was great work against Nathan Mander. Wants to go short, looking for Cal Dixon. He's got a bit of work to do, but he takes the mark now at half-back. Sweeping kick out wide it was there towards Luke Van Ray. He's got Peckett on short, finds him at half-forward. So Peckett's got McGarry over the top. He'll go to him now. He does. McGarry's got a little bit of space. He needs to kick it. Great work there by Haddock. He had no one to go to, and taking the mark there was Cal Searle, who's been one of Mornington's best this afternoon.
Yep.
goes across to Scott Matthews. Matthews has got a duck and weave. He's falling into a wall and a sea of red and white. Little handball over to Franchino. He's in some trouble. Got a handball out. Needs to work in there. Great work there by David Hurst. Grabbed the footy. Kicks it at long again. But again, no one home for the Bulls. And taking an uncontested mark was Michael Bray. Plays on immediately. The tempo lifted in this final quarter. Much more free-flowing so far in the early stages of this final quarter. Goes up. Charalambos come down hard. That was where the all come from. There's two players down for the Bulls. Keep an eye on that one as Adrian Speedy takes the mark at half forward for the Doggies. So Charalambos is up, which is good news. Just getting up now is Kel Dixon, looking a little bit winded, but they're both up and on the jog now. So that's good. Good news for the Bulls.
And they clashed heavily, Towie, on the Boss Sports replay.
Adrian Speedy will kick on the left foot from half forward. It's probably beyond his journey. It is. He pulled it right through for a minor score. So it's 5-15. Geez, they've been inaccurate this afternoon. 45-11-13-79. That's on the pest-free scoreboard.
Towie, I think it's a result of the defensive pressure of the Bulls that they're so inaccurate.
True. Goes out towards Dan Noble. He's got the ball now. So Dan Noble, defensive pocket for the Bulls. They don't panic in these situations, Coringle. They just take their time. Aaron Paxton's got it on the very last line of defence. Needs some movement further up the ground. Eventually just decides to handball the ball through and through for a minor score. So not sure what that achieved because he was in exactly the same spot and they're restarting play again. Comes out towards Tim Hurst. He couldn't take the mark. Franchina, it's not. It's Stewie Seeger, in fact. He coughed up the footy, though. It comes out to Cal Dixon, who's recovered. Goes out wide looking for Luke Van Ray. Gets the ball now. Sweeping left handball it was. Terrific to David Hurst. Had a bounce. Haven't seen this for a while. Gave it off to Charalambos. Kick inside was beautiful to Michael Burke. Wonderful football by the Bulls, and it all started at half back with Luke Van Ray.
Well, if that was the result of handballing it in through for a behind, Towie, it definitely worked.
That's it. They unloaded, didn't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, they did.
Deep in the last
they
line.
They did. It took four kicks to get to Burke, and now he lines up about 45 out directly in front.
So this for goal number 5 for Michael Burke. Comes in, will kick from 45. I think he might have pushed it across the face. He has, just beyond his journey it was. They move on to 11-14-80. Coringle leading Mornington 5-15-45. Callum Searle straight down the ground. Kicks it up there towards Jackson Calder. Standing there was Troy Hode. Probably should have been paid the mark. It wasn't him, in fact. It was Kane McKenzie. And eventually the umpire will come in and bounce. Centre of the ground. The Bulls in control of this contest. We've played 4.5 minutes in the final quarter. Good work by Goodall again. Comes down there towards Franchina. Got a little kick forward. Wasn't effective. Speedy. A little handball out towards Ryan Smith. Kicks it to the point of the square. Needs a mark. Bray couldn't take the mark. Bain at the fall of the ball. Moss, right foot snap for goal. Through for another minor score. And short pass said a moment ago that the defensive pressure has caused the points. And no question about that, because again, he was pulled off the footy as he had a shot for goal. Terrific play. Luke Van Ray kicks the ball straight up the middle of the ground. Goodall didn't take the mark. I think he was surprised at the ball that he had an opportunity to mark. Umpire Peter Marshall's found a free kick going to Matthews, wants him to come back over the mark. They need to move it quickly. We've played 5.5 minutes. Time running out for the Doggies. They need to kick a couple on the trot. Goes up towards full forward. Bray comes out. Oh, no free kick. He took his eye off the footy and crashed into the back of Grant Goodall. The umpire said nothing there. There he is again. Luke Van Ray gives it out to Timmy Hurst. And Timmy Hurst takes the mark on the outer side at half back. So just waiting again for something to present itself. It does now. Michael Burke, terrific play. Led up the ground a long way from home.
Yeah, a long way from home, Towie.
But presented the option for them. He's got the ball at half back for the Bulls. Happy just to waste the clock at the minute. Kicks it up there towards half forward line. Franchina at the fall of the ball. Kicks the ball up towards half forward now. He's got Daniel Moss. Can the ball sit for him? It does now. He needs some run from inside. Gives it over to McDowell. McDowell goes in short to Calder, and Calder takes the mark. So Jackson Calder takes the mark about 40 metres out from goal. He needs to get a wriggle on here. They trail 5-15-45 to 11-14-80. It's 35 points the difference. This 9. 6.5 gone.
Can't... It would be a miracle, Towie.
He's kicked the goal, though, for the Dogs. It's just what they needed. The crowd need to get behind them now, get the horns beeping. There's still plenty of time in this contest if they can string a couple of goals together. It's something they haven't been able to achieve all afternoon is to kick two on the trot. But a good goal there to Jackson Calder, and that's his first goal for the afternoon.
Absolutely, Towie. I can feel Calder's frustrations because all day there's been two or three up on him and the ball just hasn't been delivered well to him.
So back in the centre of the ground again, Holt with a bit more vigour in the middle of the ground on that occasion. Comes out towards Peter Bain. He needs to bend over and pick it up. Good play there by Moss. Picked it up at half forward. Kicks it up to, up and under. The umpire said we'll pay the mark. The Kooringal back line though, led by Luke Van Ray, brings the ball to ground with Daniel Moss. And the umpire will restart play. 50 metres out from the Doggies' goal, kicking towards the main street end in the final quarter.
Modder's head comes on for the Bulls, Towie, and Tim Hurst comes off.
And there's David Hurst, his brother, who grabs the ball now at half-back, kicks it up there towards half-forward, but the ball goes over the line out of bounds, almost knocked our cameraman completely off his perch. Courtesy of the MPNFL, who've put together a lovely little construction there for them while our boys, our station manager, was down here putting up a tent himself this morning.
Just it's a very impressive tent, though, Taylor.
The support is something else. I tell you what, James Cameron's got the footy now on the wing position for the Doggies. He kicks the ball in towards 50. Jackson called a flu, couldn't take the mark. Good haul at the fall of the ball, did the roving work. The ruckman, as he kicks it up and under. Dale Alanis with the big fist came through. Justin Peckett's in there for the Bulls as well. Doggies doing well in this situation. Seager gives a little handball off, kicks it up forward again. But once again, there he is, LVR. Takes the mark. Luke Van Ray switches play. Good work too. Finds Ambrose. Half back line. Didn't give himself enough space. Kicked it to the man on the mark. Good work there. The Bulls are able to drive the ball forward again. Going hard there. Michael Burks leading in the race for the footy. Just laying the tackles nicely. Pulled off the ball there. Could have been a free kick. Comes out to Alanis. Flying shot at goal. And there's the nail in the coffin.
Not what the Doggies needed, Towie. The Bulls being able to score quite easily after some defensive footy was impressive by the Dogs then, but unfortunately Bulls be able to get a score on the board.
So terrific work by the Doggies again as Michael Bray comes off the ground. Nathan Mander going back on. Will go to full forward for that tall target. Gee, they've missed Warwick Miller this afternoon. They won't be... Daniel Villani and Chris Paxino won't come quick enough. They're about two or three wakes away, the pair of them. Back in the centre of the ground, Grant Goodall's been sensational in the ruck this afternoon for the Bulls. James Cameron puts his head over the footy, but he's well tackled. As Christian Bleisner prepared to come back on the ground. Coming off the ground there is Nick Shaw, who kicked a goal. Cameron kicks the ball up towards the forward line, but again, a sea of red and white. They're able to work the ball out. There's Troy Hode, little left foot kick. There's Luke Van Ray again. How many this quarter, Geordie King?
That's his fifth.
Fifth possession there for Luke Van Ray. Lovely kick in towards the centre of the ground. Just a little bit too high there for Rambo. Sweeping handball was terrific. Comes down there towards Kel Dixon. Another one there to Motorshead. Motorshead kicks it up there towards Burke. Burke, a little handball give. Trying to get somebody to run onto it. It's David Hurst, couldn't get it. Eventually it comes out there towards Baker. Sweeping handball to Matthews. Matthews to Searle. And the Doggies can reload from full back. Kicks it long towards the wing position. It was a hopeful kick. It went to no one in particular. Cal Dixon runs onto it again. A leaping kick in towards full centre half forward. Fall of the ball there was Hurst. Kicks it towards full forward. Bleisner's got a couple to beat. Fall of the ball. Hard there was McCleary. He's got a couple to beat. Bleisner, a little right foot snap. And it went through for a minor score.
Bulls just being able to lock the ball in then.
So it might have been Charalambos who kicked the ball in. But Barry Smeaton's got the ball. Defensive pocket there for the Doggies. Wants to go long. Does so now. Now goes up towards the wing position. That's a wonderful mark there by Kane McKenzie. He's taken a couple like that this afternoon.
He has, Towie McKenzie. Fantastic grab.
So Kane McKenzie unloads, goes long. Justin Peckett's got a few to beat. At the fall of the ball there is David Hurst. Goes hard at it, but the boundary line beats him and it goes over the line. And it'll be will play, will restart. Right forward pocket for the Bulls. They lead it nicely. They lead 81-51, 5-goal margin. We've played 11 and a half minutes. Ball tapped in. Great work there by Peck. It was able just to knock Cameron off the footy. Could have got tripped. Then he could have got one in the back there from Justin Peckett. The ball comes up there towards Hode on the wing position. Calder's got some work to do for the ball. Gives it backwards. Good work there towards Chris Baker. Baker for the Doggies from the wing position. Loads. Goes towards full forward. Nobody can take the mark. Good work there by McKenzie at the ground level once again. Picked up there by Moss around the corner. He's found someone on this occasion in Speedy. It went over his head. He's got time to recover. Gets on the favoured left foot and snaps around the corner through for a minor score.
The story of the day for the Dogs today, Toey. Just another point.
So the Doggies, that's what, point number 16. 6 goals, 16-52 to 11-15-81. We've played 12 and a half minutes in the final quarter. Ball comes out again. Noble tried, should have punched from behind. Jackson Calder almost took the mark. They're all wrapped up in there. In there is Kane McKenzie. Also in there is Tuller Motors Head. So we restart play. Goodall and Holt, they've been going at it all afternoon. Little handball give was good. Seager, left foot snap around the corner. Cameron went with the one arm, couldn't take the mark. Going in hard there was Moss, could have given away the free kick. They're still battling in there, and eventually the umpire will come in and bounce.
It's good to see, Toey, that both teams are still desperate at the footy.
Yeah, even though there's, 10 minutes left in the game, and it's pretty much sealed, isn't it, at the moment, with Coringle just dominating at the moment. Comes out towards Chris Baker, and Baker takes the mark on 50 for the Dogs. He's a long kick normally, gives it to his coach in Seager. Seager has a shot for goal. He hasn't got the journey, though, and it goes through for another minor score, so there's point 17. No, point 18. 16-18 to 11 goals, 15. We've played 13 and a half minutes. The ball comes out to Luke Van Ray. Takes another mark. Runs on. Kicks it up towards half forward. Justin Peckett's given his opponent the slip. He's got Tim Hurst, but he decides to go long towards Burke. Burke trying to body off his opponent. Joel's got to go in there to support. Good work there by Matthews for Mornington to see the ball over the line out of bounds. So Tuller Motors Head coming off the ground. Had a good game this afternoon. Coming on for him is Jackson Matthews. So the umpire ready to bring the ball back into play. The only bit of sunshine out on the ground over in that pocket. Michael Bray just got pushed out of the way. There's Michael Burke. Ducks, weaves, gets on the left foot, goes in short. That's a wonderful kick.
Great centering ball.
Spotted up Jared Eames, who takes the mark about 25, 30 metres out from goal directly in front.
It's going to hurt, Toey.
It is. Eames yet to kick a goal this afternoon for the Bulls. They've had plenty of goal kickers, and they've all been their smalls. Jared Eames, usually a beautiful kick of the footy. And he'll line up, as we said, from about 30 metres out from goal directly in front. 30 points the margin as we approach the 15-minute mark of the final quarter. The result, beyond doubt, the margin is still open as Jared Eames has kicked the goal for the Bulls.
Fantastic goal.
No, kicked a point. Oh. He's missed it. 12 goals, 17-79 to 6-18-54. Just
the crowd,
a bit of premature celebration there from us on that occasion.
Well, I mean, I followed the 456 people in attendance today, mate, that thought it was a goal, so I got excited.
Jackson Calder takes a mark in the centre of the ground in front of Dan Noble. He's had it tough today, Calder. Goes out wide looking for Speedy. He's been one of their best this afternoon. How many for Adrian Speedy?
He's had 23.
23 touches. He's certainly been one of Moynton's best this afternoon once again as the ball goes over the line out of bounds. And the Doggies staring down the barrel of three straight defeats this afternoon.
Yeah, that'll hurt, Toey.
Two close ones to both Seaford and Bomb Beach, who were sitting second and third on the table, and now they've lost to the fourth place side in Coringle. So a bit of soul searching to do for the Doggies through the week as Byron Holt gets the tap on this occasion. Aaron Paxton's been terrific. Great tackle there by Moss, but the umpire said a bit zealous over the shoulder, and Aaron Paxton will get the free kick. Wants to go out wide. There he is again. Luke Van Ray had the ball on a string all afternoon. When we're looking at Boss Sports best on ground this afternoon, it's going to be hard to go past Van Ray as the ball comes out there towards Joel. Taps it in front of himself. Should have got rid of the footy instead. He's got one for free for two high. Not sure how he got that one. He should have given the ball off. And it is. He's got the free. I'm astounded.
Yeah,
he's got
so
the free.
I'm just looking at the Boss Sports replay, Toey, and I can't see anything in that. But
there was nothing, and he's a bit lost down there again. Is Joel didn't know what to do with the footy on that occasion. Eventually comes out to Hode. Hode goes to the centre of the ground. Nice mark. Nick Shaw wants to give it to McGarry. He does. McGarry got one across the chops. Finally kicks it up towards Eames. Timmy Hurst at the fall. The ball's got a couple to beat. Left it for his teammate there in Nick Shaw again. But the Doggies' defence were able to get it out on this occasion. Comes down there towards Moss. Moss with a right foot kick in towards full forward. But again, terrific work by the defence. And I think that was Jack Johnson, who's taken the mark with the long sleeves on defensive 50. Goes out wide, wasn't the greatest of kicks, didn't give Big Bleisner a great opportunity, but the big fella's able to pick the footy up, but not before the boundary line beat him. And there'll be a boundary throw-in. Wing position out of sight of the ground, the Bulls in full control. We've played 17 and a half minutes final quarter.
Not much now, Toey, that the Dogs can do to obviously get back, but they just need to stay strong. And as I'm saying that, there's been a beautiful mark.
There has Tamanda, who had much more time and really should have done better with that opportunity. Instead, he just unleashed the footy and kicked the ball out of bounds, left forward pocket for the Dogs. Not great play again by the Doggies. The ball comes back into play. Bleisner's got the front position, tapped it down. James Cameron's got the ball, trying to get out of trouble. Right foot snap. It's a goal.
It's a goal.
Good play there by James Cameron. He becomes the first multiple goal kicker this afternoon for the Doggies with two. And Mornington trail now by, it's 60 by 29 points. You're listening to RPP, the voice of Peninsula Football.
Are you concerned for your family about the use of toxic chemicals by pest controllers? You'll need to think very seriously about Plug-In Pest Free, the environmentally responsible approach to the control of rats and mice and cockroaches. Pest Free has been scientifically tested. It's Australian made and it's consumer proven since 1995. Order your Pest Free unit today for only $99.95 and receive 2 years free warranty and 30-day money-back guarantee. Call 4969-5515 or visit pestfree.com.au.
Station sponsor.
19 minutes gone, final quarter. The ball goes up towards half forward. Going there is Baker, but the ball goes over the line and out of bounds. Pest Free scoreboard looks like this. 7 goals, 18-60 Mornington to... That can't be right, can it?
It's
only 19
it's
points the difference, so we're not going to read the scoreboard. It's about 29 points the difference in favour of the Bulls, and that is on the Pest Free scoreboard. Boss Sports this afternoon looking after us with the best on ground this afternoon. Start thinking about that, Geordie, your best on ground. Also, use short pass to who we're going to award the Boss Sports best on ground to this afternoon. Right in front of our commentary position, umpire Pete Marshall looking a treat, freshly shaven legs. Suntan looking magnificent as well as the ball goes up towards full forward. Burke, ball hit the deck. Eames, Baker there again. Dodges, weaves, gets a handball out. Was just hoping on that occasion for his teammate there in McCleary to go with it. Couldn't do it though. Joel lays a good tackle there to hold the ball in. And eventually umpire Pete Marshall will come in and bounce again. 20 minutes gone, final quarter. The Bulls in control. They lead by 5 goals. Good play there by Bray on that occasion. Comes down towards Ambrose, up against the boundary line. Right foot snap. It'll go across the face. Joel and Matthews leading the race for it. Matthews was first one there. Got a valuable 20 metres on his kick, but eventually it goes over the line and rolls out of bounds.
Desperation footy by the Dogs now. Just don't want to increase that lead that that the Bulls have got, Toey.
So we're about 60 metres around from the Bulls' goal. Bleisner has been fantastic as a backup ruckman to Goodall this afternoon. The ball goes up towards the wing position. James Cameron, good tackle, good nudge there. Oh, Daniel Noble's gone down and he's gone down hard. Keep an eye on that one out on the outer wing position. He's gone down very hard, grabbing hold of either his knee or his ankle. So in the late stages of this game, does not look good as the Dogs are in attack at half forward.
Making his way to his feet, Toe. He's up but limping heavily on his... on his left
foot. Yeah, they don't want him to go down either because they're not blessed with height as it is at the moment, Coringle. And to lose Dan Noble's been doing a terrific job across half-back so far this season as the ball comes there towards Paxton again. It's not Paxton, in fact. That was Jake Jackson-Matthews who got that ball. Justin Peckett went without it. The ball still in the centre of the ground. Going in hard there was Coyle. Handball to Franchina. Franchina goes short, looking for Mander. Overcooked the kick. Goes dive on top of it. Should have been in the back, but wonderful work there by Jack Johnson once again. It was 2-on-1, and he was able to prevail by locking the ball in. Terrific work there by him. 22 minutes gone, final quarter. Bleisner gets a tap towards Hode. Hode kicks it up towards the wing position. Great mark there by Ambrose. So the Bulls still attacking hard in the latter stages of this final quarter. Charalambos wanted it at half forward. Ops to go short, looking for and finding Sam McGarry. So McGarry's got the ball now on the wing position. Umpire calling him to play on now. Goes up the line. Terrific kick, wasn't it? Found Charalambos. Almost got his head ripped off. The umpire said nothing in it. Joel once again tried to do a little bit too much. Coughed up the footy. Get the ball there is Matthews out of the defensive zone. Kicks it up there towards... was Franchina, in fact, who kicked that ball up towards half forward for the Dogs, but it stacks on the mill. And once again, the umpire will come in and bounce.
So just Cole, having a look, Toey Noble over the other side of the ground with two trainers, just making his way slowly back to the box. So it's not looking good.
So the ball comes out towards Justin Peckett. Ducks, weaves. Just got caught on that occasion, old Frankie, and he coughed up the footy. And said, look, if you want the footy, come and get it because I'm not going to give it back to you. And there's a 50-metre penalty against him as well. So prevented the Mornington players from getting hold of the footy and taking possession of it once again. So umpire Peter Marshall said, we'll have none of that. Let's just get the footy back and I'll take you 50 metres closer to goal.
He's glistening out there, Towie, Peter Marshall.
He is. Looks a treat. Absolute treat he is. As the Dogs need one here. Coming in for goal. And again, sprayed it across the face through for another minor score. So it's 7 goals, 20, 62 to 12 goals, 16, 88. 27 points the difference. That is on the pest-free scoreboard.
Well, as the Bulls get ready to bring it back in.
So it almost took the mark there. That was Damien McDowell. Couldn't take the mark. They dive on top of it. Good tackle there by Aaron Paxton. And Paxton's able to hold the ball in. Coringle still swinging the changes. Their midfielders coming on and off the ball. The rotation through the forward line, through the middle, and then on the interchange bench. Working well for them today. Plenty of run the Bulls still late in this game. Good work there by Joel just to tap the ball in front of him. Bleisner goes, hacks the ball forward. Charalambos needs some support. Overcooked a little bit for Big Bleisner. For the ball was Bain. Gave one out to Searle. Searle gets tackled nicely. Comes towards Charalambos. Slipped over at the critical moment. Baker comes out with it for the Dogs. Runs towards the wing position, kicks it up towards full forward. Jackson Calder's got a couple to beat. That's been the scenario all afternoon. Seager, right foot snap around the corner, looking for a teammate there in McDowell. McDowell's got Cal Dixon to beat. They all dive on top of it. Troy Hode comes in too for the Bulls. Anthony Franchina just pushing them out of the way. The umpire letting the game go. James Cameron's in there, still trying to get the ball out. Finally does to Franchina. Right foot snap, Daniel Moss around the corner. Has missed though. And through for yet another minor score. So it's 7 goals, 21-63 to 12-16-88. 25 points the difference. Goes up towards half forward again, the Bulls. Tapped away there by Matthews. He's been pretty good today for the Doggies. Barry Smeaton goes short, looking for and finding Nathan Mander, who takes the mark at half forward for the Doggies. We've played 25 and a half minutes in the final quarter. Not a long time to go, you wouldn't think. The ball comes down towards Jackson Calder and Bleisner. They both bring it to ground. And the umpire will come in and bounce again. Half forward for the Doggies. Just been overwhelmed today by a more professional outfit in Coringle. They're able to put the foot on the gas. Defensively, they've been outstanding this afternoon. Comes out towards McDowell. McDowell just kept it in front of himself. Barry Smeaton cops one, then he wants to go on with it with Jack Johnson. And Barry Smeaton, an angry, angry little man he is. Always gives his all for his club, though. always gives his all for his club as he gives kicks the ball across the face of the goal. That's a terrific mark.
Great mark.
Wonderful mark there by the coach in Stewie Seeger. Knows that he hasn't got much time left.
Yes, it is.
He's got zero time left, in fact. And the coach, who hasn't been able to get the journey this afternoon, let's see if he can finish off with a goal. He kicks and kicks the goal. He misses. So that's been the story of the day.
It has been.
For the Doggies, and kicks yet another behind. And the final score is 7 goals, 22, 64 to 12, 16, 88. We'll go to a break and we'll be back with the final quarter wrap.